Hello and welcome to this demonstration of the tracking software used in two of CellScale's products, the BioTester and the U-Stretch. First thing I'll do with this demonstration is pull open a set of test data using the Analyze and Review feature. And I have a test here that was done on a 6mm by 6mm piece of rubber. And what was done in this test was to do a single cycle where it was stretched from its initial configuration to 20% equibiaxial strain in 20 seconds. And it was held in place using biorake grips, which are have five tines with 1mm spacing. The surface of this rubber was speckled with some graphite powder, which is a common technique used to provide some texture to the surface of the specimen to aid in the tracking procedure. And what I'm going to do first is create a track set where I'm going to track just some specific points that I select. So I'll call this 4 points. And I'm going to start at the unstretched configuration and follow some points through all of these 20 images up to 20% strain. I'll click on the add feature to add points to my initial image, and I'll select some features, for example this black dot here and a few others on the surface of the specimen, and I'm going to use the default parameters to follow those points through this 20% motion strain. Happens very quickly because there's only 4 points, and if I play back that motion we can see that the tracking has been successful in following those points. What I'll do is also play it back showing the displacement. I'm just going to change the coloration of that a little bit to show so you can see the line more clearly. I'll show it in green, for example. And here you can see the trace history of those points as they move while the specimen is being deformed. Alternatively, what I could have done, instead of tracking some individual points, is to track the motion of an array of points. So I'm going to call this array, again from the very first unstretched image to the full series, full 20 images. Instead of clicking the add features to add individual points, what I'm going to do this time is select a box on the surface of the specimen, and I'm going to put an array of 6x6 points inside that box. Excuse me. And again, clicking the track points using the default features. This takes a little bit longer. Instead of just the 4 points, I have 36 points, an array of 6x6, and stepping that through 20 images. So just give it there. It took about 25 seconds total. And once that's complete, I'll then select these images and we can play this back and see those points. I'll just change the color there so you can see that a bit better. Make that red and a little bit bigger. There we are. And if I play that back, you can see those points moving through time following the specimen. And much like the 4 points, I can also show the array of points and show their trace movement. The last thing I can do is I'll step to the last frame is also show the strains because I've tracked an array. And here we can show, for example, the X strains, and I'll show the text for those X strains here. And let's make the strains in a red color so we can see them a bit more clearly. And we can see here we do in fact have about 20% strain with some variation, and we can also look at the Y strain just to verify that it was the same. And that's really one of the main purposes of doing this kind of tracking, is to be able to verify that the strains based on the grip motion are in fact the strains that are seen by the material. Sometimes these values aren't really the same, and that can be because of local failure where the grips are attaching to the specimen. They could be tearing or pulling of those points. And also what we can look for is areas of the specimen that are not seeing uniform strain due to variances in the thickness or the material properties at various points, or maybe there's some local failure. So we can see a lot of different things. I'll just jump over and show the as a coloration scheme rather than as a as looking at the numerical values. And I did one earlier which had a lot of points, and I'll just show you that now, which shows the kind of thing you can get by tracking a very large array of points, more for a qualitative understanding of what's happening in the specimen. I hope this video has been helpful in explaining the features of the software for the BioTester in the U-stretch, and explaining why these image tracking is useful for further understanding the results of your test. If you have any more questions about this or any other of CellScale's products, please feel free to contact us.